Welcome to the session. This is the first live session for the course, and we will be having two live sessions every week for each and every module. In this module, I'll just share what exactly we are going to do. So this is module one, and in module one, we are going to look at the working of the internet. What is internet? It's a network of networks. The network of networks connected all across the globe is known as internet. In this specific week, what are we going to look at is, what is an IP address? What is a top level domain? What is a subdomain? Protocols for the internet. WordPress.com as a platform to host your own website. And self-hosted WordPress website. What is the difference between hosting your website on WordPress.com and what is it to host it on a self-hosted server? So we'll look into the difference between the two. In this specific module, you will get all of these topics, and the task for the week is to set up a domain of your own on WordPress.com. The first thing that you need to check out is the lesson. This is a text lesson wherein you will be introduced to the concepts of the different topics that I just mentioned. It will give you an in-depth understanding of each and every concept, whether it is about a domain name, how should you select a domain name for your website, what is a TLD, that is a top-level domain, what is a subdomain, and what are subfolders. So all this you will get to know within this lesson. Then we have two live sessions. As I said, every week, every module has two live sessions. This is the first session that we are having right now. The next session we have in a couple of days, and that will be to look at any glitches if you are facing for the task completion. Next are the resources. These are the presentations that have been put up on SlideShare, so you can check out these presentations, and they again will explain the various concepts to you. That is about the IP address, TLD, that is the top level domain, and protocols. What are protocols, and protocols specific to the working of the internet, that is transferring of data over the internet. And then we have the discussion forums. We have two discussion forums per module, majorly. And in this specific module, we will look at the IP address. Why is it important to have an IP, to have a domain name instead of an IP address? What is the role of an IP address? So after you go through the lesson and the various slides on SlideShare, you should be able to understand what is an IP address and how to figure out a valid domain name for your own website. Next is the HTTPS. Why is it important to have HTTPS? This is one of the protocols that we have, and majorly being used because of security reasons. So again, we will look into it in a while. And if you want to know more, you want supplementary reading, so I've put up additional links for supplementary reading, which you can check out. So here we come to WordPress.com. How are you going to register for a domain name on WordPress.com? First, you need to get into the website, WordPress.com. Then click on Get Started. Then is when you enter the details, that is the email address. Choose a username for your account. Enter the password. Or you also get an option to log in through the Gmail account. If you've already logged into your Gmail, you can use that email ID to log in for your WordPress website. Next is to enter the details. These are important details. So you should have already figured out what all is your website going to be about. So specifically, what is the name going to be? And what are the goals behind having a website? So you will have to enter all of those details here. Next is to select a domain name. If you already have a domain name, that is, if you've already purchased a domain name, you can link that here, or else you can enter a keyword or a name for your website. And WordPress will show you the available names that are available for free, or if you want to purchase them. So if you want to purchase, suppose I selected Live a Life as the name of my website. So livealife.online was a good match, but it is a paid domain. As you can see, it is included in paid plans. But I prefer selecting a free domain, so I selected livealife.video.blog, and this is what comes for free. So I went ahead with that. So you can choose if you want to purchase a domain name for your website, or you want to go in with the free one. So select the free one. That's what I would suggest at this stage when you are trying it for the first time. So select a free domain name. Next is to select a plan. Again, you get an option to select a plan according to the requirements. So for now, I again suggest to go with a free plan and start working on your website. Later on, if you would feel the need, then you can always upgrade to any of the plans. After you've selected the plan, then you get access to the dashboard of your website, that is the backend admin area of the website. Here you will get an option, as you can see, you get an option to launch site. Do not launch your site at this stage because we are not yet ready with the content, and we are only setting up the domain name for now. So once you click on launch site, it will get indexed on Google. And if it gets indexed on Google, then your pages will start appearing. So before you have, it is not a good idea to launch it at this stage when you have not set up all your pages and blog posts and added your media files as you would want to. So this is where you need to stop for this module, because this is about setting up your domain name on WordPress.com. In the next session, we are going to look at task completion, that is setting up your domain name that we just discussed, and check out the details of domain name that almost everybody would have purchased by then or set up by then. Let me just go to all right, here is the course that we have, and this is week one. In week one, as I just discussed, we have a lesson plan, getting started. Then these are the live sessions. We were having some glitches with WizIQ, so I had to schedule it through Zoom. And then we have the presentation resources that I talked about. Let us see, what is an IP address? Working of the internet. How does the data get transferred over the internet? Internet is a virtual world. It is a network of networks connected across the globe. Every device connected to the internet owns an IP address, which is specific to that device, whether it is your phone, smartphone, or your tablet, or laptop, desktop. Any device that is connected to the internet has to have an IP address. Internet works on client-server architecture. Client sends the request and server responds to the request. So the big question is, who is a client and who is a server? This is a user who wants to surf the internet. So he logs into the machine. The machine that he is using will be known as the client. And this client will have an IP address. He wants to surf to google.co.in. And when the request is made over the internet to connect to google.co.in, the request gets converted into the IP address equivalent of google.co.in. This request is forwarded to the ISP web server. ISP is the internet service provider, that is the service provider who provides the internet connection at your place, whether it is your home or office. And then that request is forwarded from the ISP web server to the server where google.co.in is hosted. And this specific machine, since this is also connected to the internet, this specific machine also owns an IP address. This is the exact IP address to which the google.co.in was converted into at the time of sending the request. And this IP address, that is the server, when it receives a request, the request is checked for authentication along with other security parameters. And after checking the authenticity, the response is sent back to the client. And that is how the client is able to see google.co.in. Now, if you can see, if you want to own a website of your own, that is suppose codewizacademy.com. I would also need to host it on some server, and on that server, there is going to be an IP address of that specific machine. So now we know that internet works on client-server model. Every device connected to the internet owns an IP address, and every website that resides over the internet owns a specific IP address of its own. When a request is made to navigate to a website, its domain name is converted into IP address equivalent. Data from this address is returned to client as response. This is the entire cycle of transferring of data. Now we will look into what is a TLD, that is a top level domain. When we talk about domain registration, we have to understand what is a top level domain, what is a root domain, what is a subdomain, and domain registrar. So easy to remember, alphanumeric address of a website is known as a domain name. It can be alphanumeric, that is, it can include alphabets and digits. Website is hosted on a server. Server is connected to the internet. Hence, it owns an IP address that we just saw. And the website is located on the server, hence readable through its IP address. So what is that IP address converted into? That is converted into the domain name. What is that domain name? We refer to it as URL, Uniform Resource Locator. We start to decipher the URL from right to left. That is the rightmost word that we see after the dot, after the period, is the place where we start deciphering it from. When you see here, .com. So com is a TLD. That is the top level domain. The rightmost of the period was com, and that forms the TLD. The exact name of the domain that you want here, it is Google. That forms the root domain. And towards the left of the period of the root domain will be the subdomain. And towards the left of the subdomain could be another subdomain, but it is mostly www. What is a subfolder? A subfolder is the folder, the name that comes after the forward slash. So the rightmost part of the domain name after the period is, it could be .com, .edu, .co, .us, .in. These are country codes. So you will see that country codes come in a pair of couple of alphabets. .us is for United States, .in is for India, .eu is for Europe, .au is for Australia, .net is for networking, and .org is for organization. So nowadays we have a variety of other top level domains available which you can choose from. Name of your website, that is the root domain. This is the custom name, which can be purchased by the owner, and it has to be registered with the domain registrar. Now, when you select a domain name on WordPress.com, that specific domain will be registered with the registrar of WordPress.com. If you ever want to migrate your domain to some other server or hosting provider, then you will have to register it with the other domain registrar connected to that specific company. But not to confuse yourself, so right now we stick to WordPress.com. And when you select a domain name on WordPress.com, it will be registered with the domain registrar of WordPress.com. Subdomain, that is the part of the URL towards the left of the root domain, not including www. For example, mail.google.com. So here mail is a subdomain. We have course.codewaysacademy.com. So course is a subdomain. What is the difference between a subdomain and a subfolder? A subdomain is basically a separate form. It is separate from the root folder. It is not included within the root domain. So here, if we see course.codewaysacademy.com, course is a separate folder. It's a separate domain within WordPress.com, but does not reside inside Codeways Academy. It needs to be linked to the root domain. It is not linked because it is not within WordPress.com. So you will have to externally link it. And a subfolder, whereas, would be the space or folder within the website, that is within the root domain. Part of the URL followed after the forward slash is the subfolder. As we saw, mail.google.com/mail. Now, this slash mail is a subfolder, whereas the mail towards the left of Google is a subdomain. Codewaysacademy.com/blog. This is a common subfolder that you will see with most of the websites which have a blog post. And this is a subfolder within the main root domain. Similarly, codewaysacademy.com and tutorial. So tutorial is a subfolder. So that's about the subfolder. Now we will look into protocols. What is a protocol? It is a set of rules that govern the functioning of the internet. These are the internet protocols. What is HTTP? Hypertext Transfer Protocol. This means hyper means something that can be linked to another piece of data within the same document or to an external document. So when we surf through the internet, we see that we are linking different pages. These are all done through hypertext, that is the linking of text, images through HTTP. Hypertext Transfer Protocol Secure is what is HTTPS. Whenever you will see a padlock in the address bar, this would mean it is secure and it will be followed by HTTPS. That means the padlock basically means that it is secure. Why do we need HTTPS? The data that is transferred over the internet is encrypted using this protocol. What is encryption? Encryption is the process of converting plain text into non-understandable format using some algorithm. So basically, we use certain algorithms which convert plain text that we have written as content of our website to be converted into encrypted form. Encryption is a two-way function where the data is encrypted and decrypted for accessibility. Algorithms which are used for a secure transfer of data are AES, PGP. These are commonly used algorithms for symmetric and public key encryption, respectively. So we do not need to get into details of the process of encryption, but this is just for information. These are certain algorithms that are used. Hashing, what is hashing? It is a one-way function which is used to get a fixed length hash value of any data provided to the algorithm. This is good for understanding cybersecurity because this is how the data is secured, whether you are on the internet or you are offline. Even when you are offline, there are certain scenarios when you would want to secure your data. Maybe you have a file that contains passwords. So to secure that file and not to keep your passwords as plain text, you can use hashing algorithms to convert them into hash values. So majorly used hashing algorithms include MD5 and SHA-256 that are used to validate the digital signatures of SSL certificate. When we talk about HTTPS, S stands for secure, and S is when you get with the SSL certificate. SSL stands for secured session layer. So SSL certificate is important and it works on the MD5 and SHA-256 algorithms. If you read about the hacks that have happened in the past, were majorly because the algorithm that were being used for hashing were not updated. And they were not secure because these algorithms keep on improvising and new algorithms keep on coming because hackers find loopholes with the algorithms and then it's when they are rendered useless. Next, we have FTP. FTP is file transfer protocol. This is the protocol that is used for transferring of files and it allows continuous downloading of the files. Again, to have a safe and secure transfer of files, we use FTPS, that is FTP secure, or SFTP, that is SSH FTP. These are the two forms of FTP protocol that we use for transferring of data over the internet. Why is FTP important? Because when you will be working with your website, you will have to upload a lot of files to your site and you can use FTP protocol to transfer data on your website. So FTP account for, it is used for restricted access. Whenever you, if ever you plan to outsource your website development or a part of website development, or could be a scenario in future, then you always need to give restricted access. And how do you do it is by creating a separate FTP account only to that part of your site, only to those folders of your site which you need to give access to, not to the entire website. We will take a look into that when we come to cybersecurity and website security in the future modules. Next is UDP, User Datagram Protocol. This protocol is connectionless protocol, and this is a specific protocol used majorly for live streaming because it has low latency, and this connection is, since it is connectionless, so it can tolerate loss of data, which is why even if you see drop the network signal dropping while live streaming, still it continues to a major extent because it uses UDP. And that's about the protocols. Now we will go back to the website again. Okay, so these are the three presentations that we have. Next we have coming up is the discussion forum, wherein we need to discuss about the IP address and HTTPS, what all we have understood, and how do we look at it in terms of the website hosting. So that's about this session. Any questions or any doubts if you have regarding the content or the activities? I will be putting up this specific presentation on the course so that you have the steps to follow for setting up your domain name on WordPress.com. So if you have any queries, please let me know in the chat. Or if you want to talk, you can unmute your mic and talk. I do not see any messages coming up. So I presume everybody's understood everything, and let us see how it progresses through the week. So I'm looking forward to a fruitful working in the week. Thank you. Thank you very much for joining in, and hope to see you in the next session. By then, you should have set up your domain name. Thank you. You're welcome. Take care.